swash player has been made. We are trying to check the basic features of this very swash player. Okay, we are trying to connect the push shots here, and you know, try to make some, you know, change of the angle of attack. So now we have the pull up, like when you want to pitch up, your cyclic control when you want to pitch up, like take off. So this is it now. And coming to the other side, we have like here, if you want to go left, like your cyclic movement. So we have it here, go left like this way, right? And here you have your, so now you can like rotate to the prop and you know, see how it works. Like, you know, here now we have the control center here, and let's see how it works. See, so now I want you to take this very close to this. What really happened? Now we can pull it off from the where we hang it for the text. Now let's see. Now pull it off. Now this is your main rotor head. Okay, I want to show you something specifically. Here I have my bearings in the middle here, and that serves as the push up, and I don't know what you call it. It's not a cyclic. It's a pitch control, like something like this. So here there is a bearing working that makes it like pull up. And here we have, just take a good look at here. Look very well. You see what happened in here. We have something like a bearing working. Now just watch. Okay, let me turn the prop from the head so you can see it very well. Now watch. I want to show you. You watching that? What is happening here? You see? You can turn it how that like. That is to show you there is something here, like a bearing in here. It's a cardboard, but once the rotor rotates, it's turned with this very component here. It's different from, you know, the plate, you know, all that. So now let me show you. Look very well. Just watch out. You can see. You see that? You see that turning? Like, can you see that? Very well. You see? No, just watch very well. You can understand. You see something here turning like a bearing. I don't know, it's just the main part of it. So you watch it now, you see turning while the main rotor head is still strong and tight, you see. So this is just about the swash plate I made. Let me turn it again so you can see very well. You see it? You just turn it and the main rotor is in there. So this is the swash plate. And now let me show you how it is done. Watch very well. I made the descriptions very easy. You understand? So here we have, you go left or right. We have some other control like this. You know, you can move back, forward, left or right, you know. And we have a cyclic, your pitch altitude, like this is it, you pitch up. Now you watch the prop angle of attack changes, and this is your main shaft, your gear shaft, you know, moving to your engine or motor or whatever, or your electric anything. This is your main shaft, gear shaft. This is your swash plate component. And here, everything about aircraft is being done, like very simple this way. And something, this very bearing here is very, very important. I don't know, you watch very close how it works very perfectly, especially here in the middle of this very swash plate. I'm gonna turn it around a little bit so I can watch very well. Here, you see how the control, I mean, the specific component works. So I'm gonna try to turn it again. Watch very close here. Now let's turn it. See what is happening? Just watch. Okay, you see what is happening? I'm turning the rotor. You see? You see what is happening here? You see? So So once the engine keep increasing, you know, it keep changes in angle of attack. So that is it about the propeller, you understand? And here it is super made. It's just home built anyway, but was good idea. I really love that. Okay, so right now let's try put it back to the hanger and let me try to pull it off like normal. Okay, let me pull them off here. We got a joint here, we have to pull it off like this, and it's off. And come in here, another one here, we'll pull it off just slowly. This is now the roller blades are being put back, and this is all about your propeller. Okay, I try to bring you this video so you can feel it, how you can make your own easy swash blade for ROC. And now we'll try to pull back to the original, you know, fixing, and here it go. So you have a cyclic movement at the blade, and you have your forward and back movement. You have your pitch altitude, you know, and your splash blade, of course. You can keep everything neutral, like changing blades, you know, directions, and let's keep it neutral and see. So this is the neutral state, and let's roll the rotors, see? So it was super working. I really love this project. So now it almost off. So this is all we got for you this video today, and thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe for more top videos. I try to bring this up for you, and it's very interesting project. You know, many people have been having issues how to, you know, try to fix and work on their rotor blades and swash blades, you know, all that. But this is the basically idea how you can start up as a beginner, how you can try to put something down and know how it actually worked out. Though it might not be perfect, but it's gonna give you an idea to start up with something. And of course, through time, you're gonna be perfect, and you can use some other. There are some other methods that you can use to work on this Freddy rotor swash blade prop, and you can still get everything right. So this one, very one, it's a beginner's guide. If you wanna think about something like your swash blade, you can start with this kind of prototype. Then when you build it out, you can know actually what you're looking forward, what you really want to, and how you just figure out to be. And now you can move forward with your advanced techniques and know materials and make a high advanced swash blade. So thank you and subscribe for more channels. See you, and don't forget, this is kensmithrachelchannel.com. So you subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video. Thumbs up!